The American story is one that can be told from a variety of angles, which is why we've taken a trip next door to the National Museum of Natural History. Today we're going to learn a little bit more about one of America's most celebrated naturalists, Teddy Roosevelt, who actually contributed to this museum in a way that might surprise you. Darrin Lunde, who is the collections manager in the Division of Mammals, and we have quite a few mammals here to look through. So Darrin, can you tell us a little bit about this whole line?
This is a tray of voles.
Voles.
Yeah, a kind of rodent. They were all collected by different individuals at different times.
Okay.
And what makes this interesting is mixed in, suddenly we come upon some that were collected by Theodore Roosevelt.
Nice.
And, yeah. And if we look even more closely, we see that they were collected by him in 1870, which means he would have been 12 years old when he collected these specimens and prepared them.
Now, where would he have learned to do that?
Roosevelt was a lifelong naturalist from the time he was very young. And the American Museum of Natural History was actually founded in part by his father. The charter for it was signed in his front parlor in their living room.
Well, that's convenient.
In 1869. So he was there when that museum was founded, and he was there when they were establishing their first exhibits and unpacking their first specimens. Roosevelt, when he was young, he originally was very interested in birds. That was his passion. And later in life, he got interested in bigger, not necessarily dangerous, but sort of bigger, bison and bears. Mm-hmm. And the reason for that is he had a growing awareness of the fact that these small mammals were not nearly as threatened as the larger mammals. He also had a need for adventure, like for manly adventure. Mm-hmm. And so the naturalist in him always was interested in birds and voles and all the little things. There was an element of adventure and manhood in these big specimens that attracted him more.
So when he becomes president, obviously it's not as if he has to put away his naturalist side.
No, he was always a naturalist. Even in the White House, he was famous for, you know, interrupting cabinet meetings to look out the window and note on a particular, you know, birds that were migrating through. And in fact, there was even one famous incident where he burst into a room and he said, "Do you know what happened?" And everyone was just like, "Wait, like what? What world event? What?" And it's just some warbler that he had seen. It's like way early and it shouldn't be here at this time. And, you know.
Like, so great, he was always president. We're so glad.
Yes. And as a politician, because of that love of natural history, he was very much interested in protecting wildlife and wildlands and animals.
So is that where this special vole off to the side comes in?
Yeah, he procured this specimen. Again, I pulled these out because we have the vole he collected when he was 12 years old. And then later on in life, when he's president, he's still at
it. He's still doing it.
He's still at it. And so the story behind this is he was with John Burroughs, the famous naturalist and writer. And they were in Yellowstone. You can see right here on the tag where they were. He was riding around in, I believe it was a sleigh, being pulled through the geyser regions when something caught his eye. And Roosevelt, imagine this. So Roosevelt's president of the United States, mm-hmm. right? Jumps off this moving thing, pulls off his hat and captures this thing and says, "I've got to send this to the Smithsonian." He said, "I've got to send it to him. This is important. It's from Yellowstone, from this remote area. Got to find out what it is." And here it is. It's here. And it's the only specimen that I'm aware of an actual cataloged mammal in a museum that was actually collected by a sitting president. You know, we've got lots of specimens from Roosevelt here.
Yeah.
But this one, he was actually in the White House and collecting and donating specimens. That doesn't happen today.
Yeah.
Or at least not recently. We haven't gotten any specimens from any recent presidents, but we would gladly accept them.
Again, on the other hand, feel like it, you know.
Yeah. Well, Roosevelt wasn't collecting this because he said, "I'm going to be famous someday and I want people to know that I collected." No, he collected this because he was a naturalist. And I look at this as a naturalist.
Yeah.
I understand. I get it. I'm in total agreement with Teddy.
Yeah.
I can think back to him collecting these, you know, more than 100 years ago and say, "Yeah, I know you collected these because you wanted them to be part of the scientific collection. And here they are.
And here they are.
We're not going to set them aside except when given to us."
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. This has been both unique and much furrier than most of our other episodes, so I really appreciate you doing this.
It's my pleasure.
And thank you all for joining us again today. Hope to see you back next time.